You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Tuesday, January 12th, 2021. This week on the Catholic Sprouts podcast, we are answering the central question that we all have to answer as Christians. And this question is, who is Jesus Christ? Now, spoiler alert, we already know that he is the Messiah, the Son of God, but we are going to go through all of the reasons why this is absolutely true. The first reason that we know Jesus is God is because he heals and because he works on the Sabbath. Now, let's talk about this. Now, if you go back into the Old Testament, remember the Old Testament can also be referred to as the Jewish scripture. They are all of the prophets from the Old Testament, the story of creation and the formation of the Israelite nation. Now, through all of those stories and books in the Bible, that is how the Jews came to understand who God is. In one of those books written by the prophet Isaiah, the prophet Isaiah talks about the nature of God, and he was revealed this in a prophetic vision, and he talks about God alone is able to heal the lame, cure the sick, that the ability to heal and cure, this alone is an ability of God's. Now, Jesus comes on the scene. If you have read much about the Gospels, you know that Jesus spends a lot of his time healing, restoring the sight of the blind, curing lepers, curing paralytics. Now, he's not standing with a big sign saying, "I am the Messiah." But for a Jew that knew scripture, that knew the writings of the prophets, he would see a man healing and he would say, "This is God, because God alone is able to heal." Now, one of the most important stories for us to really understand that Jesus is God and to hear him tell us this is when he heals a poor man by the side of the pools at Bethsaida. Now, this is a story from the book of John. Now, what happened is that this poor man who is very sick, he was laying beside these pools outside of the temple, hoping that he would be able to get in and bathe because miracles sometimes happened and sick people were sometimes cured. It was a Sabbath, a day when, especially if you're a Pharisee, they allowed absolutely no work to be done on the Sabbath. Jesus comes upon this poor, very pathetic man. He's been there for a long time, for years even, trying to get into these waters to be cured, but people keep pushing him out of the way and he can't get into the waters. Now, Jesus sees him and is feeling pity for him, and he asks the man if he wants to be healed. Eventually, Jesus does heal the man, and he commands this man after he is healed to stand, to pick up his mat, and to carry it. Of course, things go poorly for this man very quickly when the Pharisees see him because he's carrying his mat, and they are very strict. No work on the Sabbath. You can't even carry your mat. So he gets in trouble, and of course, this poor, pathetic man explains that a man named Jesus has just healed him. Of course, the Pharisees go and talk to Jesus and accuse him of working on the Sabbath. Now, instead of denying that he was working on the Sabbath, he asks them if they suppose that God works on the Sabbath. Now, of course, God is working on the Sabbath because everything we do and everything we are depends on God. If God were to stop, everything would stop. Our life is through God. So, of course, they admit that God does work on the Sabbath, and Jesus says, "And therefore, so do I." So, the interesting thing here, my friends, is that this is Jewish culture. They oftentimes gave indirect answers, but Jesus is giving an answer nonetheless. He is saying, Just as God works on the Sabbath, so do I, because I am God. Now, I know that might be a little bit of a confusing story for you, but nonetheless, the Jews would have seen this and they would have understood, if their hearts were open to it, understood that this indeed was the Messiah, because he was curing as only God can, because he was working on the Sabbath as only God is allowed to do. Now, we are going to continue on and talk about many other reasons why we know that Jesus is God. But for today, I want you to resume the challenge that we are doing all week. Remember, the name of Jesus is a powerful prayer because it is the name of God himself. Say it 5 times prayerfully, reverently, with your whole heart engaged, and ask Jesus to come be with you.
That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God created you to be.
Just one more thing. As we go through this series investigating who Jesus is, I invite you to recommit to Eucharistic adoration as a family or individually. Remember, Jesus Christ not only existed 2,000 years ago, but he is truly present in our churches, in our tabernacles, and in our monstrances during Eucharistic adoration. To support and encourage you to get back into the practice of Eucharistic adoration, we have deeply discounted all of our adoration materials, something for each member of the family, through the month of January. Please grab a resource or find whatever you need to get back and to worship Jesus Christ, truly present in the Eucharist.